With the king of my heart, like, how does that song resound to you? King of my heart.
For me, the reason why that song speaks to me is because Jesus to be the king of everything, amen? And no matter what we do, no matter where we are in life, I think Jesus should be ahead of us always. And he's the one that we can trust on. We can lean upon no matter what situation we find ourselves in. And so, king of my heart, I think God is definitely our king.
Amen. Without further ado, King of My Heart by Robbie, Shayna, Hazel, and Becky. This is Shayna, you guys. So what made you start music?
I guess my mom. She would have sing when we were in church and stuff when we were younger. So
So if you guys are, if you have children and if you want them to be musical, make sure you push that music onto them so they can be in their chamber. It works. But so without further ado again, give them all to Jesus.
Amen. And how many of you have ever tried to fix that problem or trial or struggle in your life by yourself? Yeah, I am definitely guilty of that. And so much so to the point that it led to a point in my life where I actually was like in depression, very, very anxiety and things like that as well. But this song, Give Them All to Jesus, this is a song that we should really just have on our hearts and in the forefront of our minds all the time. Because you just realize, a lot of people think the Christian lifestyle is just going to be an easy flowing, like smooth sailing, vacation every day of your life. But the reality is, as you heard in the messages earlier as well, it's like when you're a Christian, you will go through trials and you will go through tribulations because we'll help you find it. But the only way you can be successful in those is if you give those trials and struggles to Jesus. Amen? Amen. So I pray that you guys, if you know the song, feel free to join us along and sing along and fun little hymn. So,
are you tired of chasing the ingredient? Oh.
You know? It was just so uplifting and comforting as well, because give them all to Jesus. Like, how comforting is that for us to just lay it down on His feet, all the things that we carry as burdens. So, our next, we have a special guest actually. One hails from the Philippines, and one hails from Fresno. And they're actually brothers. And they're going to be singing a song entitled Grace.
Grace.
But before that, I just have a quick question. So this is Jed. Where do you go to school?
I go to school at AUP in the Philippines.
And what are you studying to be?
I'm studying nursing.
Ooh. Why?
Because it's in my blood.
It's in his blood. And Tenora, that's the mother and uncle. The proud parents there. Good job, because I went to the Philippines too for school. It was a great journey. And the brother, what's your name?
Jazz.
Jazz, what do you want to be in the future?
Nurse.
Hope it's safe. And Tenora, pleasing. Can you raise your hand? But you guys raised some wonderful kids here. And I have one more question, just for each of you. So Jed, how much do you love Jazz?
Oh, it varies.
That's very, very good. Okay, and for Jazz, how much do you love Jed?
I would have to say the same thing.
Yeah, it varies. And that's very, very good. So without further ado, Grace.
Before we start singing, there's this verse, 2 Corinthians 12:9, and it says, "And he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you. My strength is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, most gladly, I will rather boast in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me." Sometimes in our daily lives, we get so busy, we forget about God, and we feel like we're in this on our own, but we have to remember that no matter how far we get, and no matter how much we forget about Him, He will always welcome us back into His arms. And that's what the song is about.
Each time I will fall short of your glory. How far
so full, vivid. Like the violin, the piano, the harmonies. Good job, guys. And with the next song, we'll be listening to Becky. We'll just give her a quick second to set up. So Becky will be singing Troubled Soul. So this song will just be a solo, and she's going to be playing the piano, and she will be singing.
I started writing it a few years ago, but I only had little fragments here and there. As anyone who writes poetry or music will know, that's pretty common to just have little pieces here and there. But what really brought the song together for me and just kind of dealt it was I was speaking with a friend of mine who had been going through some depressive episodes, circumstances, let's say. And he grew up in church, just like me. But what bothered me was that he was going through all of this in the meeting room, and he didn't feel like he could really share it with, you know, his friends, pastors, church members, whatever. And that really struck a chord with me that, you know, here we come to church every week, maybe sometimes multiple times a week, or maybe we're here every night, and we see people we know, so we can, you know, see strangers, hi, how's it going? And that's about the extent of our conversation a lot of times. And it would do us individually, at least as a group, so much good if we really took the time to ask, how are you doing? What's going on in the world? How was your day? How can I pray for you? Because that's what we're here for as a church family, right? Like, you can worship God by yourself anyway. But one of the big things, one of the big reasons why like, God has set it down for 60 Assembly of the Brethren is because we're here for each other as well, and to build each other up and to pray for each other. So really take the time to do that, and just ask somebody, how can I pray for you this weekend? See what happens.
One has been with you all.
My child, I promise I'm with you through it all. Our next song will be by Shayna. She actually wrote this song entitled Simple Complexity, and she'll tell us a little bit more about it, about her song and how she wrote it.
Thank you.
listening to the version, that version. But our next song, it's going to be more of a congregational singing. It will be When We All Get to Heaven. And Sheena said, it's a new version. The new version.
Thank you.
thank you for what we just witnessed today. Thank you for the talents that you've given each and every one of us. And may we continue to use it for your glory. And again, we ask for the Holy Spirit, help us to be changed, help us to be renewed. And may we have the mind of Christ. And I pray also for your special blessing on the Songbird Studios. May it be that they continue to keep on going. And you continue to give them and equip them and encourage them in their ministry. And I pray also for Remy's Keith as he speaks after this. May your words speak through him.